My name is Jonathan Bloch, and I'm the curator of vertebrate paleontology at the University of Florida's Florida Museum of Natural History. And our project is one that comes out of about 8 years of work in the Bighorn Basin of Wyoming, paleontological work. And our field work, that is the work where we went out and actually collected fossils in the Bighorn Basin, is in part funded by the National Science Foundation. The reason we are focused on, we have been focused on this field area in Wyoming is because it represents a really fantastic record of a global warming event that happened 55.8 million years ago. This global warming event happened over around 200,000 years, and it was about 15 degrees of temperature shift. So this represents a very fast warming event of very high magnitude that is similar to the kind of warming we might expect to see in the next couple of hundred years on the planet. What we found was a new species of extinct carnivore. This is the jaw of this animal. It actually had been discovered about 20 years earlier, but we only had a fragment of a tooth to be able to look at. So this was a remarkable discovery in the fact that we found the complete right and left jaw. And one of the things that we were very interested in looking at was what does this tell us about how animals might respond to the global warming event? Prior to this discovery, we already understood that animals that ate leaves, that is herbivorous mammals, were very small during this global warming event. By comparison, here is the lower jaw of a modern horse versus the lower jaw of what the horses look like during this global warming event. You can see that they're much smaller in size, and we knew that that was the case prior to this study. What we didn't really understand was that the carnivorous mammals, that is, mammals that ate meat, also got smaller. So the ancestors of this new species of carnivorous mammal, which we called Paleonictus wingi, were probably around the size of this grizzly bear here, so this brown bear. What this shows us is that during this global warming event, this carnivore went from the size of something like a large grizzly to the size of a small black bear. And we think that the reason for that may be related to the fact that the carnivores became small because some of their prey became small, so the animals that they were eating became small, as well as just the simple fact that when temperatures become warmer, mammals tend to become smaller, and this has to do with their thermoregulation. That is, they have much larger surface area to volume as they are smaller than if they are larger. They have much less surface area to volume, so it's actually much harder for them to lose heat. So this explains why, for example, you get smaller brown bears in places like Montana versus in Alaska. So there's a good reason for why mammals would get smaller during a global warming event. What we see as a result of the discovery of this really interesting new species is that that in fact does happen, not just in the herbivores, but also in the carnivores. And that should be interesting to all of us, because what it shows us is that global warming can have a profound effect on the evolution and distribution of mammals on the planet. If you want to learn more about our study, you can go to the website for the Journal of Mammalian Evolution, and our article is available online.